Forest Commander Edition 2014 introduces layer and entity transparency. Let's add transparency to this crosshatch. For that, the first option is to go to the Layer Manager. Search for the layer of this entity and change the transparency factor. We select this layer and enter the transparency factor here. Let's enter 40%. A value of 0 means 0% transparency or no transparency, that is, opaque. We define a transparency of 40%. To increase the transparency, we could enter a higher factor, like 70, for example. We click OK. The crosshatch has become transparent, and we see some of the white background behind it. If the object does not look transparent, there could be two explanations. A problem with the graphics card, or more likely, you could have disabled any transparency in Options, the second method. The box you see checked here is the one which globally activates or restricts transparency. Here is another interesting parameter, which determines whether locked layers may be shown with transparency. This can instantly simplify your drawing and make the other layers more visible. If defined to 0, there's no transparency. Let's lock the layer of the street pavement. Ours tells us that this has been successfully locked. However, nothing changes visually in the drawing. We can't see any difference between locked layers and other layers. So let's go back to Options. And we'll change this to 90% transparency. Now we can see how the locked layer is transparent. Mixing the color of the entities with the white color of the background. So, we have two ways to define transparency. We can easily define the transparency of a layer or of a specific entity. Or we can globally change the transparency of all locked layers within Options. If we want to make one specific entity transparent, we select it and change its properties. So, you can control the transparency of an entity either from the Properties palette or by changing the transparency percentage of the layer to which it belongs.